Good morning children, welcome to your chemistry online class. Last class we have discussed a lot of properties of organic molecules and we have seen how to name each organic molecule. Today we are going to discuss about isomerism. What do you mean by isomerism? Isomerism is the property of organic molecule which shows same chemical formula but different physical formula, or same chemical structure different physical structure. We'll see one by one. So isomerism mainly classified as two, that is structural isomerism and stereoisomerism. Structural isomerism, it is the isomerism in the structure, the difference only in the structure. The structural isomerism is further classified into chain isomerism, position isomerism, functional group isomerism and metamerism. And the stereoisomerism, it is about the optical activity, that is geometrical isomerism and optical isomerism. We will see its detail. First one is structural isomerism. In structural isomerism, we will see chain isomerism. Chain isomerism can be defined as when two or more compounds have similar molecular formula but different carbon skeletons. These are referred to chain isomers and the phenomenon is termed as chain isomerism. So the two structures is known as chain isomers. The phenomena is known as chain isomerism. For example, you can see the pentane. If you check the pentane, its formula is C5H12. Its chemical formula is C5H12. So it is a straight chain structure. And if you check with isopentane, that is 2-methyl butane. If you check its formula, it also contains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbon. And if you count the number of hydrogen, that is 3 plus 3, 6. 6 plus 1, 7, 7 plus 2, 9, 9 plus 3, 12. It's also having this same molecular formula, but the structure is different. Here it is straight chain, here it is branched. And if you check with neopentane, that is 2,2-dimethylpropane, in the second position, it's having branches. If you check its chemical formula, it is also having 5 carbons and 12 hydrogen, C5H12. So if you check this compound, this skeleton, the carbon skeleton structure is different but same molecular formula. Such type of isomerism is known as chain isomerism. Any difference in the chain structure, then it is known as chain isomerism. Next one is position isomerism. In position isomerism, when two or more compounds differ in the position of substituent atom or functional group on the carbon skeleton, they are called position isomers, and this phenomenon is termed as position isomerism. For example, the molecule having the chemical formula C3H8O, and if you check this, the functional group is OH, that is propan 1-ol. So its position, the OH group position in the first carbon, so propan 1-ol. If the position of OH group in the second carbon atom, structure will vary but the formula will be same, that is propan 2-ol. If it is in the instead of alcohol, if it is aldehyde, maybe the formula will be same but the structure will be vary. Such isomerism by the difference of the position of functional group or substituent atom, such isomerism is known as position isomerism. Next one is functional group isomerism. How can we define functional group isomerism? We'll see. Two or more compounds having the same molecular formula but different functional groups are called functional isomers. And this phenomenon is termed as functional group isomerism. We'll see an example. For example, the molecular formula of the compound is C3H6O. And if you check here, it is C double bond O. So it is a ketone. Its functional group is ketone. If you check here, it is aldehyde. The functional group is C double bond O H. It is an aldehyde. It is a ketone. Both having the same molecular formula. Such, if there is difference in the functional group, then it is known as functional group isomerism. Next one is metamerism. It is arises due to different alkyl chains on the compound. The alkyl chains are vary in the compound. Such isomerism is known as metamerism. The next type of isomerism, main branch of isomerism, is stereoisomerism. We'll see what is stereoisomerism. That a compounds have the same constitution and sequence of covalent bonds, but differ in relative position of their atoms or group in a space, are called stereoisomerism. This is also about in the space. Their arrangement of the atoms will be varied. That is, special type of isomerism is called stereoisomerism, and it is further classified into geometrical and optical isomerism. So, this all about isomerism. We'll see fundamental concepts in organic mechanism. In an organic reaction, the organic molecule reacts with an appropriate attracting reagent and leads the formation of one or more intermediate and final product. So, an organic reaction first will start with the organic molecule. It is known as substrate, and it is reacted with a reagent. And first stage we will get sometimes intermediate, and from the intermediate we will get the products. Sometimes we will also get byproducts. So substrate is the reactant which supplies carbon to the new bond, and to the other reactant is called reagent. If both reactants supply carbon to the new bond, then choice is arbitrary in the case of molecule on which attention focused, called substrate. We'll see reaction mechanism. Reaction mechanism is a sequential account of each step, describing details of electron movement, energetics, how each bond is cleaving, and that is breaking, and how a new bond is forming, and how will be the rate of the reaction or transformation, and what are the reactants will get, how the reactants convert to products, that is kinetics, is referred to a reaction mechanism. How a reaction is occurring and what type of bond cleavage, what type of bond formation is occurring, such type of things are explained by reaction mechanism. Every reaction having its own mechanism. Sometimes reactions occurs due to fission of a covalent bond, that is cleavage of covalent bonds, that is breaking of covalent bond. It is also many type. First one is heterolytic cleavage. Heterolytic cleavage, the bond breaks in such a fashion that shared pair electrons remains with the one of the fragments. Only one atom will get the shared pair electron. For example, one atom has a sextet electronic structure and a positive charge, and the other a valence octet when at least one lone pair and negative charge. For example, CH3Br is breaking, and this bond, it is denoting the bond shifted towards bromine. So, the all electron, shared pair electron transferred to Br. So, it will get the negative charge, CH3 bond will get CH3 plus charge. Such type of cleavage is known as heterolytic cleavage. A species having a carbon atom possessing sextet of electrons and a positive charge is called carbocation. So the atom which donate electron, that is known as carbocation, which carries positive charge. The observed order of carbocation stability, the number of methyl group is increasing, then stability also increasing. For example, CH3 plus having less stable than CH3CH3. So here the number of methyl group is more than CH3. Here also number of, here are 2, here 3. So the stability will increase in this order. The organic reaction which proceed through heterolytic and bond cleavage are called ionic or heteropolar or just the polar reactions. such type of reaction. That is, if a heterolytic cleavage occurs in a reaction, such reactions are called ionic or heteropolar or just polar reactions. Next one is homolytic cleavage. In homolytic cleavage, one of the electrons of the shared pair in a covalent bond goes with each of the bonded atom. Thus, in homolytic cleavage, the movement of single electron takes place instead of the electron. We will see an example, then it will be clear. For example, if Rx, that is CH3Br something, it is in the presence of, it is cleaving in the presence of heterolyte. So, one electron, we know in a bond, there are two electrons. So, one electron shared to one atom and another electron shared to another molecule or another atom. So, both will get same number, one electron pair. Such cleavage results the formation of neutral species which contains an unpaired electron. So, we will get a neutral species which is carrying one unpaired electron, that is one electron. Such species are known as free radicals. Such species are known as free radicals. So, it is an alkyl free radical, it is an halogen free radical. So, in organic reaction which proceed by homolytic fission are called free radical or homopolar or non-polar reactions. Such reactions are known as free radical reaction or homopolar reaction or non-polar reactions. And we will see some important terms in organic chemistry. Nucleophiles and electrophiles. What do we mean by nucleophile or electrophile? Nucleophile are denoted by the letter NU. So, nucleophile. Nucleo means positive. File means loving, that is positive loving. Nucleophiles are the substance which having negative charge, which attract positive charge. They have higher attraction towards positive charge. That is, a reagent that brings an electron pair is known as nucleophile. It will brings an electron, that is, it will attract the electron pair or it will accept electron pair. So, that is nucleus seeking and the reaction is called nucleophilic. Next one is electrophile. So, what will be electrophile? Electrophile having love towards electrons, that is love towards negative charge. That is a reagent that takes away an electron pair. Electron seeking and the reaction is called electrophilic. So, during a polar organic reaction, a nucleophile attacks an electrophilic center of the substrate, which is that specific atom or part of the electrophile that is electron deficient. Similarly, the electrophile attack at nucleophilic center, which is the electron rich the center of the substrate, that is the nucleophile attracts towards the positive part, electrophile attracts to the negative part. We'll see how electron movement occurs in organic reactions. The movement of electron shown by this type of curved arrows. We'll see how it is shifting. From pi bond to adjacent bond position. From pi to adjacent bond position. So, from this pi bond, here it is a sigma bond. So, this pi bond shifted to this side. So, here pi bond and sigma bond. And from pi bond to adjacent atom. First type is from pi bond to adjacent bond position. Second type from pi bond to adjacent atom. Third is from atom to adjacent bond position. These type of reactions will occur. This type of shifting is occurring. Movement of single electron is indicated by a single bar fish hooks. Like this arrow, like this. Half. We'll see how electron displacement effects in covalent bonds. We'll see this one in the next class.